In this screencast, we're going to use SuperPro Designer to model a process in which we have some kind of component entering a unit procedure and individual components of that stock mixture that was entering coming out in the outlets. And so let's pick a unit procedure. I've opened up SuperPro and I'm going to go to pick a hydrocyclone. So I'll put my piece of equipment here on the sheet and then add some streams. Here's our inlet stream. And we'll have two outlet streams. Of course, you could change the names of these if you wanted to. So what we need to do is go to Tasks, Pure Components, and register the components that are going to be involved in this process. We default to nitrogen, oxygen, and water. And in this example, I'm going to show you how to take a certain cell line like algae and separate out components of interest, in this case biomass, which would be just waste components from our algae, and the product of interest, which in this case would be our lipids and therefore our biodiesel, and we could use that as our chemicals exiting the process. So let's scroll down and find biomass, and we'll register and add that to our list. And then we could also go down, and in SuperPro, the closest thing to a biodiesel or something of that kind of form would be soybean oil, and we could register that. So you could click on both biomass and soybean oil and edit their properties in terms of their thermochemical properties and physical constants. We could go down here to our biomass and declare it as what we've entered here and change our water content if necessary. And we click OK. So now what we want to do is again go to Tasks, but now we're going to go to Stock Mixtures and register a stock mixture. Now air is by default in the process. If we click on this wand, we can create whatever we want. So let's just say algae cells and click OK. Now if we go to edit properties for the algae cells, we can go to composition and declare what makes up these algae cells. So if we click on biomass, we could click on water, we could also click on the oil, and of course there's going to be other components, but we could keep it pretty simple. And if we just say that the soybean oil is going to be 20%, this is going to be maybe 50%, and the remaining is going to be water. We could change other properties about it, the economics we could type in. Let's just click OK to keep it simple, and click OK to register our algae cells. So now, if we click on our inlet stream, we can choose algae cells as what's entering our process. So we can type in how much is entering. Let's say 100 kilograms. We could also say that water is going to enter this process, and maybe we'll have a lot more water. And I haven't changed anything else. I've just entered in flow rates for these two components. Now, what we want to do is show you that if we click on our hydrocyclone and go to our operation data, for the cyclone, let's just say that it's going to remove 80% by mass of our algae. Now if we click OK, we should be able to run our process. Then we could click on these streams and you see that we don't even have algae listed anymore. We just have our biomass and soybean oil and water coming out of our two streams. So although in the first stream we declared algae and water, we've now figured out a way to have the individual components that make up the algae come out in the product streams. So hopefully this gives you a quick overview of the necessity of declaring our individual components up through tasks, and also any stock mixtures that are a product of these individual components.